First at 5 on your news leader, a small group of Tennessee elected officials today got the chance to tour the xAI facility in Whitehaven. Good evening and thank you for joining us. I'm Greg Hurst.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Skurlock. The tour is happening as the project expands across the city and debates continue over its future. WREG's Raven Copeland joins us live tonight in Whitehaven. And Raven, what have you learned about this tour?
Greg and Stephanie, WREG has learned which Tennessee lawmakers attended today. Those elected officials are state representatives John Gillespie and Mark White, as well as Attorney General Jonathan Scrimetti. Now, as you mentioned, this is all happening as debate continues over this project. Now, this week, the city of Memphis announced the results of air quality tests that were conducted in response to concerns over turbines operated by xAI. Officials say the results did not show any dangerous levels of pollutants. However, the Southern Environmental Law Center says that out of the 10 pollutants that were tested for, ozone was not one of them. Now, you may remember just last week, the SELC and the NAACP announced their plans to file a lawsuit against xAI. As the debates continue, State Senator Ramesh Akberry spoke to your news leader about the project. She acknowledged the potential economic impacts for the city of Memphis, as well as the environmental concerns surrounding xAI.
Well, I love the concept of Digital Delta, right? We want to have high-paying jobs that really benefits our community. I like the ordinance that Mayor Young has proposed where 25% of that tax revenue will go to a community that desperately needs infrastructure development. Again, we want to balance that with making sure that it is safe.
Now, ahead at 10, I'll tell you about the debate surrounding xAI's plans for expansion. You'll also hear from a Democratic lawmaker who recently toured an xAI facility. He tells WREG about his new outlook as well as his current concerns. Reporting live from Whitehaven, for your news leader, Raven Copeland, WREG News Channel 3.